There was a time before Facebook and Twitter, when the high school reigned supreme. A time when people believed everything they read in the Fremont Tribune. It was an age when only school pride mattered, and one school was more school than the rest. Its name was Archbishop Bergan. The students were like the iPhone 5 compared to the printing press. The choir had voices that could make a Wolverine purr. Their school uniforms were so fine, they made Justin Bieber look like a bum. In other words, Bergan was the bomb. One thing was certain. During homecoming week, the school was even more proud than usual. In to cover this week's events, we are fortunate to have the members of the Channel 4 news team. Champ Kine, sports! Brick Tamlin, weather! Your reporter in the field, Brian Fantana. And led by five-time Emmy Award-winning anchor, Ron Burgundy.
We look good. Real good. Everyone, come and see how good we look. Kind of a big deal. We have many leather-bound books. Our classrooms smell of rich mahogany. Father Kiter even stops by frequently. It's a fact. We're the greatest school in the history of mankind.
And now, your Channel 4 News.
Good evening, Bergan. Bergan. What is Bergan, anyway?
I believe it's a former archbishop.
No, I can't be, I believe it's an old wooden ship used in the Civil War era. Anyway, thank you anyway, Bergan, for joining the broadcast. This is what's going on in your world tonight. Tonight's top story, the Red Flower Chinese restaurant has been closed, at least temporarily, after a customer witnessed an employee dragging a red, rotting deer carcass into the kitchen. The deer was found along the side of Highway 275, and employees were in the process of butchering the animal when health officials arrived. Talk about poor timing. Anyone else hungry for some roadkill to go? On that note, let's check on the weather with Brick Tamlin.
I love Bergan.
Brick, do you really love Bergan? Or are you just saying it because you're in the school?
I love Bergan. I love Bergan!
Hello, I'm Brick. For those of you looking to enjoy the football game this Friday evening, you can expect high temperatures and dry conditions as the drought continues to take its toll on the Midwest.
Does Brick realize that was Bolivia?
As a precaution, Bergan has taken the necessary steps to be responsible with its own water resources during this difficult time. They have gone so far as to ration student water intake during the school day.
This is all you get, to drink, to wash your hands, and go to the bathroom.
But this is not enough!
You get nothing like it!
After recent results in math competitions, Bergan has put the mathletes, led by TJ Fricklin, in charge of solving the current dry spell and water shortage problems.
I got it. Milk was a bad choice.
I found the worst part of the current heat wave has been climbing into a hot vehicle at the end of the school day. As a result, I have come up with my own method of keeping vehicles cool throughout the day. In order to test my hypothesis, I traveled to the North Bend parking lot to see if blacking out their windows will have any positive effect.
Brick, you realize that's our school parking lot?
Whoopsies. Back to you, Ron.
Thanks, Brick. Let's take it to the field with our reporter, Brian Fantana.
Uniform Watch 2012. Students at Archbishop Bergan High School have continued to gripe about the school's uniform policy and have even decided to go as far as to go on strike. To protest, the boys have worn short shorts and even skirts. Girls, on the other hand, have gone with a more boyish look. They feel that 60% of the time, it fools Mr. Rainforth every time. Back to you, Ron.
Wow, that's disturbing. Thanks, Brian. With a check on our school sports teams, we take you to Champ Kind, as he interviews Coach Joe Wokavich, or something like that. He's the head coach for a sport where apparently you just run. Reminds me of a fad I took up a few years ago called yogging. Or maybe it's jogging. I'm not quite sure if it's a silent J or not. Any of you guys know?
Thanks, Ron.
Whammy!
I'm here with cross-country coach Joe Wokavich. Thanks for meeting with us, coach. I think the big question on everyone's mind is, how did you talk that many kids into going out for a sport where all you do is run? You got any secrets?
We look for people that maybe don't understand the metric system, and we try to tell them that all the distances are measured in meters, and we tell them that a meter is actually equal to 1 inch. So when we run 5,000 meters, a lot of them don't think they're going that far, and so far that's really worked very well for us. So we've tried that, and the other thing is it's just kids that really enjoy running, I guess, so I'm fortunate that I find people that enjoy doing that.
On a more serious note, how do you feel your team has progressed throughout the course of this season, both on an individual and team level?
Kids have done really well. We've got some that have cut 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 minutes off their time since the start of the season, and I think they've just learned how to run it a little bit better and learn understand what they have to do and how they spread out their energy, and I've been really pleased. I mean, I think they've accomplished things they never expected to accomplish, and I think our times, you know, reflect that we showed great improvement.
With the conference meet in the books and districts in the near future, how do you feel about your team's chances heading into the final meets of the year?
Our district is very challenging. There's 3 of the top 10 teams, I believe, are there. One of them, Nebraska Christian, is defending state champion from last year. UTAN's awful good. Stan's very good. There's a lot of good individuals. But I think we've run in a lot of challenging meets all year long, and we face other challenges. We've run Devil's Hill a number of times. We've listened to TJ talk about quantum physics until we can't understand what he's talking about. So I think we're ready for challenges.
With TJ and Molly being the lone seniors on the team, can you speak of their leadership and what they've meant to the Bergan Cross Country program?
Well, Molly, it's her first year of running, so I think that's been hard at times for her to you know, just to deal with the distance running after she's come off track season where she's been a sprinter. But I've been impressed with her work ethic, and I think, you know, she's done good things with that. And TJ's been around for quite a while, and you know, I think all the kids kind of, those seniors have done a nice job. The other kids have jumped in. We've got kids that have been running for 5, 6, some even, you know, longer than that, as far as cross country, so I think the whole group has shown good leadership.
Thanks, Coach, and good luck with the rest of the season. We now turn to volleyball action with Coach Scott Painter. So, Scotty, I attended one of the most exciting volleyball games a week ago when you hosted Council Bluffs St. Albert. I have to ask, how did you keep from wetting yourself during that thrilling final set? I know I let a little go, but then again, I'm good for about 2 a year. Coach, you've been referred to as the Oregon Ducks of C2 volleyball with your fancy get-ups and various jersey combinations. How much time does a fella spend thinking about what jersey you're going to wear on any given day?
There are so many combinations, you want to just get it right at any given time for any game. It's amazing.
It seems there's been a big turnaround from a year ago. What would you say has been the biggest difference from last season?
maturity and growth in the girls. We were a young team last year, and this year they're with those seven seniors and that one junior. It's a big reason why. Also, we have so many weapons, it is hard to shut down five different people at any given time. We can go to any one of those girls, so I think that's a big thing or a big difference from this year to last year.
With districts in the near future, and Bergan being the hands-down favorite, what is it going to take to bring home that district championship and a berth into the state tournament?
It's going to take everyone doing their job and working together to finish the goal, as well as everyone being ready for every game and going out and taking care of the ball. Just knowing that we got to keep the ball in and go out there and play hard every game as soon as we hit the court.
Last but not least, we turn to the gridiron for our weekly segment of On the Bench with Beacom. I really appreciate you taking some time out of your schedule to sit down with us. It says here you're not only the head football coach and K-12 principal, but you're also an avid fly fisherman, amateur cage fighter going by the name Ronimal, and a classically trained ballet dancer. Care to explain yourself, Coach?
Well, I said there's, in order to be a successful person, you have to be a well-rounded person. No further comment.
Heading into tonight's homecoming contest against North Bend Tigers, I must ask, how do you plan on scoring less than 100? Because I know the last time the Wes Eichmeyer, Bergan alum, played against these guys in basketball, he dropped 59 points on him himself. Do you plan on borrowing any Coach Morrow's 8th graders to keep the score reasonable?
I hadn't thought about Coach Morrow's 8th graders. What I had thought about is Coach Morrow's signs where he holds up the plays that mean absolutely nothing. He's confused every team that he's played so far this year. I figured it might work. We could confuse our own offense and see what happens when the kids do whatever they think the sign means.
Coach, your offensive system's impressive. I mean, I want to be friends with it. It seems like every play has a chance to become a big play. Whammy! Can you tell us a little bit more about the kids that made these big plays happen?
One of the things that makes our offense special is that we've done well as a team. Everybody has a role to play, and everybody's played their part. And nobody is worried about the credit they got or the credit anybody else has had. So I'd just leave it at that. All the coaches helped me out in calling plays. All the kids executed at a high level. Every kid has had a role.
Heading into the end of the season and the start of the state playoffs, how do you see things panning out for the team?
Well, if you truly mean panning out, after all, I am an avid fly fisherman. I can see a fish in the pan over a fire. But if you want to know how we're going to do in the playoffs, I see us landing a 4 seed, opening with the 13 seed, playing a 5 seed in the second round, going to David City and beating their tail to make it into the semifinals.
Wow. You can just smell the intensity in that man's eyes. I'm not going to lie to you. It smells like pure gasoline. Back to you, Ron.
Thanks, champ. Great story. Compelling. Rich. Well, that's all about all the time we have for tonight.
Hey, Ron.
Hey.
Did you hear about this new fad that's been sweeping the nation? It's called Gangnam Style.
No, why don't you tell me about it?
Rule it.
Oppan Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. 낮에는 따사로운 인간적인 여자, 커피 한 잔에 여유를 아는 품격 있는 여자, 밤이 오면 심장이 뜨거워지는 여자, 그런 반전 있는 여자. 너는 선호해. 낮에는 너만큼 따사로운 그런 선호해. 커피 식기도 전에 원샷 때리는 선호해. 밤이 오면 심장이 터져버리는 선호해. 그런 선호해. 아름다워 사랑스러워 그래 너 hey. 그래 바로 너 hey. 아름다워 사랑스러워 그래 너 hey. 그래 바로 너 hey. 지금부터 갈 때까지 가볼까 go, 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 go. 오빤 강남스타일
오빤 강남 스타일 강남 스타일
You stay classy, Bergan.